For many years, I had been wanting to etch my own circuit boards. Doing so may be quite a bit of work, but in the end, it's much easier and much more fail-safe than using strip board or some such. Finally, after a lot of research, I can do it. I decided to go with the classic method of using ferric chloride solution. There are other methods, each with advantages as well as disadvantages. Main reason for me to work with ferric chloride solution is that purchasing this chemical is not going to turn you into a terrorism suspect. You can get highly concentrated hydrogen peroxide here in Germany, but you might get a police visit along with it. Not the kind of trouble I'd like to get myself into. To purchase ferric chloride solution, you don't even have to show your ID. Here is my shopping list. Ferric chloride solution, a copper-coated board, a flat plastic container, a permanent marker, acetone, a set of 0.8 mm, 1 mm, and 1.3 mm drill bits, and some rubber gloves. I took a screenshot of the schematic and mirrored it in the paint.net image editing program. The result was a template that I could use to design the layout on a piece of paper. I then copied the layout onto the copper-coated board using the permanent marker. Not any permanent marker works for this. I used an Etching 3000. To cut the board to size, I got myself a fancy miniature table saw. Looks cool, but in reality it's barely strong enough to cut through the material, and the blade quickly goes dull. Etching in ferric chloride solution is a relatively slow process. Using a hot water bath, I preheated the solution. That speeds up the process a bit. I put the circuit board into the flat plastic container and covered it with the solution. I used the rubber gloves to protect my hands. I kept carefully agitating the container throughout the whole process. The ferric chloride solution is not transparent, so from time to time I pulled the circuit board out to check the progress. After about 15 minutes, it was done. Yes, for 15 minutes I stood there agitating that container. I will have to build a machine to take over this task. The permanent marker can be removed using acetone. The exposed copper will start oxidizing rather quickly. To prevent that, I got a product called Lötlack SK10 by Kontaktchemie. It's a spray-on protective coating, but you can solder right through it. I drilled the holes for the components using my drill press adjusted to a high speed. I then soldered on the components. This is a 7805 based 5-volt regulated power supply circuit. Not really worth the effort of designing a circuit board, but this was mostly just an experiment. As expected, the circuit works flawlessly. Of course, the complexity of circuits is rather limited by this easy method. Since writing this article back in 2016, I have successfully tried the toner transfer method to copy layouts designed on the computer to the copper-coated board. Thank you for watching.